Okay, first import the material package. Okay, now you have to put a semicolon. Okay, so void main. Just proceed with the flow. Run app. I'll tell you. Run app.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
Run app.
Oh yeah. Run
okay. App. So run app will take a widget. No, it's not a colon. Just okay. Put parenthesis. And within that, you're supposed to give a name of a class. So that class is your class where you have the actual widgets. So what's that? Maybe let's put button demo, something like that. You're going to say button demo, right? Button demo. Okay. So button demo will have parenthesis again because we are calling the constructor. So can somebody say what a constructor is?
First thing that executes when executing the class, right?
Exactly. When you create an instance of a class, the very first method that is being invoked is your constructor. So whenever you're creating an instance of a class, you create it with a constructor. A constructor is a method which creates the instance of your class, which creates an object. So we are creating an object of this class button demo. Yeah, so you can proceed, put a semicolon there.
Okay.
So create a class that's outside void main. It has to be outside void main. Yeah, create a class button demo that will extend stateless widget. Yeah, so okay. Now type in build there, build, you'll get the boilerplate. Okay, now remove that boilerplate code in between. Are others following what he is doing? Say yes or no.
Yes.
Okay. So now we want you to create a new scaffold widget. No, first a material app. What do you do? How do you make a new material app?
We always need to use override.
Sorry, Allison, can you repeat?
We always need to use override.
I will tell you what override means. Let's not just complicate it now. I will tell you everything, each and every line of code I will explain. I will tell you what override means. So we'll proceed now. Can you return a new material app, Hamdan?
Okay.
So parenthesis, semicolon. Okay. Now within material app, inside material app. Okay. Now I want you to return a new scaffold. So how do you, no, you can't return it. You have to assign it to home. Home of material app. Yeah.
So.
So what will the scaffold take? What will be the inputs of scaffold? Can somebody say that?
Type app bar.
Yeah, the scaffold will take a app bar and a body. So can you make a new app bar?
Yeah.
So what will an app bar take?
Text, right?
The app bar will take a title.
So
the title will be a text. Okay.
Okay.
Now I have one question. Do you put a semicolon or a comma there?
Where exactly? After
button demo.
Comma.
Okay. So others, do you agree with that? Do you agree that we put a comma there?
Last moment.
Sorry? Okay, so yeah, Hamdan, you can proceed. So create a new body now.
So body should be directly below home or?
Yeah, it will be inside home. So it will be next to app bar.
Okay.
Just follow the flow. The body is a child of scaffold, right? So it has to be inside the scaffold widget.
Yeah.
Okay. So what will the body take? The body, let's have a single child scroll view. So always have this practice, because in your application, in whatever application you develop, your screen might overflow anytime. Let's say you are developing for a phone like iPhone 5 or iPhone 5S. So you know what's the size of that phone. It's like 4 inches, right? So let's say the application which you are building, you have this latest mobile phone. What's that? Let's say you have this OnePlus 8 in your mind and you're developing your application. So you have more screen space. You will think that, okay, so I have more space. I do not have to scroll anytime. There's no chance of overflow. You will think something like that. But when you deploy that same application in a smaller phone, let's say an iPhone 4 or let's say an iPhone SE on a smaller device, you will see overflow. Your application widgets will overflow. So it is always a best practice to wrap your entire application inside a single child scroll view. So whenever there is an overflow, instead of showing an error that there is an overflow, your app will start scrolling. So always keep this. This is a good practice. Just keep this in your mind. So yeah, Hamdan, we can continue. So inside the single child scroll view, we can maybe go with a column. Open that. Open the single child scroll view. This will take a child. So the child will be a column. We can maybe go with the column. Okay, now open the column. Okay, the column will take what? Will the column take a child or a children?
Children, right?
Right, so go with children. Okay, now what widgets can we have? Maybe we can go with a text and a button. Will that be okay?
Yeah.
No, you did something incorrectly. Can you come back? Okay. So the children, the column widget is taking children, right? The children is an array. It is an array. So the how do you do arrays? Arrays has to be placed in within square brackets, right?
Yeah.
So let's say you're programming in C. How do you create an array? You create an array which is enclosed in square brackets, right? Or consider a list in Python. How do you create a list in Python? You enclose them within square brackets, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so enclose them in square brackets. So within square brackets, put in your widgets separated by commas. Like very simple, guys. Let's say you're creating a list of integers from 1 to 10. How do you do that? In, let's say in Python, a is equal to within square brackets 1, 2, 3, 4, till 10, something like that, right? You separate them by commas. Similarly, in Flutter, you will create a list of widgets. You will create an array of widgets where the widgets are separated by commas. That's exactly what we're going to do now. So within the square brackets, Hamdan, put a text, maybe. The text is a widget. The text is a widget. See, whenever you're putting a colon, let's say app bar colon, it means that app bar is an attribute and you're assigning something to that attribute. App bar is a parameter, you're assigning something to that parameter. You do not do that in a list, right? A list will take the widgets directly. The list will not take any parameters. So within the children, within the square brackets, you will not take any colons or something like that. You just have to put the widgets directly. So text, parenthesis.
It's parenthesis.
Yeah. Maybe if you are confused with what you have to do, create the widgets first and then put in the details again. So we have the text, right? Just put a comma after the parenthesis and add the second widget. Maybe we can go with the raised button, R-A-I-S-E-D button. Yeah. Raised button, parenthesis, comma. Do you want any other widget? Maybe another text?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So do you get the picture now, guys? How the array is being formed? The children will take an array. The children will take a list which has more than one widgets, and the widgets are separated by commas. So you have a text widget with a comma. You have a raise button, a comma, and another text, comma. Do you see how it works? Say yes or no. I want you to respond.
Yeah, yeah.
Others?
Yes.
Do you get the picture? Do you recognize how the list works? Inside a list, there are no parameters.
Yeah.
It's just widgets. So the widgets are text, raise button, and text here again. So these widgets are separated by commas. That's how you write a list. So if you're confused with what widgets are going on, like what if I miss parentheses, what if I miss commas, if you're confused with that flow, I would suggest create the widgets first, just put the boilerplate, just like Javi has done here. First make the text, then put the raise button, then again some text. After you've created the boilerplate, put in the contents inside. So now you can start filling in the contents stuff. So inside the first text, maybe put some random text, something inside. The first parameter will not take any, you can just directly put in, you don't have to mention text.
Oh, okay.
What can we write? So maybe
button or something.
Okay. Okay, all of you, maybe you are executing your programs, right? From now on, take screenshots and document them, because we might ask at a later point of time to check if you are actually working or not. So maybe you take screenshots of whatever output you get. Okay? Okay, so maybe you fill in the last text as well. We'll do the raise button after this. Just put maybe hello world.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So do you get the flow now? Do you see what has happened till now? We put in a text, then a raise button, then another text. Within this raise button, I will tell what has to be done. Open the brackets within raise button. The raise button will take a child. So in that child, the most common practice that we put in is a text. So maybe put a child there, a child. The child will be a text.
So,
within text, maybe we can put click me, right? Click me or tap me. Okay, so run this app, we'll see what happens.
I'm not sure whether my emulator is working, but let me just try.
Wait. I think I noticed the problem. Can you click the drop down?
Yeah.
Okay. Click on the first device. Try running it now. Others, you are doing this parallelly, right? Just try running the app.
It says on press is required.
Okay, I'll say what that is. Did you get something like this? Sharon, maybe try hot reload. Others, do you get an output like this?
Still showing previous output.
Okay, maybe try to kill the app again, like just kill it completely and run it again. Do not use hot reload, run it again.
Skin.
Okay, so did you get an output like this, others? Okay. Yarkla varala, Michelle?
No, I didn't get it yet.
What seems to be the problem?
It's still on the previous output.
Oh, just kill the app and run it again, because we have completely erased it and typed it from the first. The widget tree will be messed up. Just kill the app and run it again, maybe.
Okay.
Just stop the app. You see that red color stop button, right? Press that. Stop the app and run it again. Daniel?
Yeah, da.
So, output on the chada?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. So, just take 2 more minutes. See if you got this output. Yarkadu varalaya? Alina? Okay, Alina has got it.
Yeah, I got it now.
Okay. Silas? Silas, Roshita?
Yes, sir.
Roshita, did you get the output?
Hi, yes, sir.
Okay. And who else is there? Raksha, Sneha, Vidya, Tony, the worker, chada. Tony Ajay. Guys, just notice this thing. In a program, do not just focus on what we are programming, just also focus on the style. In this or a style follow up to program, that plays a major role, because if you keep typing programming again and again, it will not work, because you will miss semicolons, you will miss braces, you will miss parentheses, commas, you will miss them all. Just follow the flow, just observe what kind of style we follow to program, that plays a major role. You know, if for example, let's say you're going to introduce a widget in between two widgets, like how we introduced a single child scroll view before. We introduced it between the scaffold and the row, right? And then you have to copy it completely, you have to cut it completely, make a new widget and then paste it inside. Instead, the shortcut was just click on the widget, left side where that bulb will show up, click on the bulb, click on insert new widget. That's a shortcut. So observe the programming style also, that matters. That will increase your speed also. Right? Okay, so I think we can continue. Let's do something now. This button, can you try to click this button? What happens?
Nothing is happening.
The button is actually inactive. It's grayed out, right?
Yeah.
Others, is your button grayed out or illiterate or the functional?
Grayed out.
Okay. It's because we don't have a method called as onTap. OnTap in Solitaire, there's a parameter, we haven't defined it. Let's see how to do that now. Can you come to this raise button? Okay, so after the child, create a new, like open this new thing, new parameter as onTap, after the text widget, Okay, onTap. Okay, I think it's onPressed. It varies the widget, it's on pressed. Okay. So on pressed, put parenthesis. No. On pressed colon, parenthesis, and now braces again. Braces.
Braces.
Curly brackets. Okay. Now just type in print hello world. Or just print this button was tapped. Print parenthesis, this button was tapped. Okay, after the print statement, put a semicolon. maybe this print statement, you can have it in the same line. I will tell you what that is. Have it in the same line. You have opened the brackets and you pushed it to three lines, right? Maybe have them in the same line. Okay. So hot reload the app now. I will explain what this means in a while. Just hot reload. Open the emulator. Try to click the button. Okay. Do you see the output?
Yeah.
Where do you see the output? Yeah.
Down in the console.
Yeah. So others, can you get the same output? Do not confuse now. I will explain what that parenthesis, what the curly braces mean. I will explain in a while. But just let me know if you get this output. Take like 1 minute, get the output, let me know if it's done. Done.
I'm not output the on the hello chat. World print statement.
Yeah, sorry, Michelle. Can you repeat? Hello?
I can click the button, but then I don't get the hello world.
Okay, can you check the onPrest thing again? The onPrest argument again? Like after onPrest, you are supposed to put parentheses and braces again, and within braces, you are supposed to print. You're supposed to type the print statement. Did you do that? Like, check if that flow is correct. I will tell you what that means in a while, but see if it's right. Have you done it properly?
Oh, wait, okay. It's all okay.
Rahul, each time we run the code, it automatically gets saved.
Yeah, if you're using Android Studio, then your program is saved automatically.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Even if you hot reload.
Yeah, even if you hot reload, the program is saved automatically. Like, even when you make a small change, the program is saved. You don't, like, it's not that your program is saved only if you save it. Whatever changes you make, they are saved automatically.
Okay.